Good morning. It's 7 December 2012. Good morning, Søren and Professor Brian Cox. At the beginning of the week, I said to you, I will get back in January 2013. That's impossible. And I now know why. Because I have to explain you something about the skill of a future bringer. We go back a longer period in time. I have explained you all about my skills in connection with the International Criminal Court. Why I call myself a future bringer and what I think that a future bringer is and what its role is on Earth, next to science. And I have written some poems about time traveling. You, physics or chemics or any other scientists often dream of building a time traveler's machine. Yeah, from the position of a future bringer, that's a heroic thing to do, especially when you don't have knowledge on psychology. And this is where I step in. You have the formulas and all the knowledge about technology, how materials connect with each other or refuse to connect. I only have psychology. I have to stick to my own timeline. I'm speaking too quickly. I may not skip a part. Okay. I think I told Brian about my skill on 30 December moving on into January 1st every year. I don't know for sure anymore if I also told Søren about it. I told you that since 5-6 years I have the skill to evaluate the year, to evaluate EQ on 31 December 2012. And the next day, January the 1st, when I open my eyes, I can actually see what will happen that year. And what I see is all kinds of images, moments on the timeline together. It's not really together, it's also on the timeline, but that's my body, my soul, my EQ, and the speed of thinking in my system. That doesn't have to be identical to the speed of thinking in your system. Especially not. Now you work via formulas and I work via atmospheres. Like the sonar system of a blind person, a deaf person. My sonar system is in exploration and development. Your sonar system does the same thing, only you have another part. Now you want to build a time traveler's machine. I have already said you can't. You cannot build a time traveler's machine when you don't understand how time moves about in the people's brain. Well, I think I also told Brian that I was very disappointed on 31 December 2011 going on into January the 1st, 2012. I suddenly had the feeling that I had lost my skill to predict the future. Now I'm wiser. 11 months later, I'm wiser. On January 2012, I opened my eyes and I felt absorbed by chaos. And I thought, oh, this is it. This is the end of my skill. I have lost my timelines. I need to develop something new in myself. I don't even know what it is. The power is bigger than myself. I'm much stronger than I am. I'm much stronger than my personality. For God's sake, what do I have to do now? 11 months later, I know that I did not lose my skill. What I saw on January 1st was the increasing chaos in the Netherlands and worldwide. But chaos in images on a timeline is a completely different emotion than true predictions of the future on a timeline. chaos itself has its rhythm, and you can only discover it when you're not afraid of chaos. You know that in your world, and then you put it in your comfortable formulas, mathematics, chemics. I envy you, you know, you can work with formulas, I don't. Then you get some kind of answer, and that can be new chaos, or that can be the beginning of a solution for a problem. Well, I have the same thing, only I discover now, the first week of December, that I did not lose my skill, and something else. It's one month before 31 December 2012. That means that now the gods and goddesses and the galaxy have decided that I need to evaluate 2012 one month earlier than I did before in the previous years. That's new to me. And I really don't know how I will feel tomorrow, because what I am doing here is new. A new part in the EQ crowd in my system. So here am I, somehow relieved that I did not lose my skill. I have predicted chaos. Well, I can assure you that you don't want to know what's on my mind for 2013, because that's also new to me. 2012 is not even finished, and 2013 is approaching. And I was used to approaching information for the future bringer on the 1st of January. So I'm not in panic, and my brain is hard working. I know I need to do a few things, and that's what I'm doing here. I can't go any further today unless I make this video. You know, going back to my experiences with chaos, answer. We can also conclude that the little mistake CERN made in connection with traveling material at the speed of light was also calculated by the galaxy itself. When you came with the news that you have discovered that materials can travel faster than the speed of light, I said to you, the gods and goddesses, the gods and goddesses are teasing you with satellites. If there's something with plug and play and the satellites. And yes, months later you discovered that there was something with plug and play. Only not in the galaxy as I thought, but on Earth. That means that the gods and goddesses have teased you, and that they involved me. Now, why did they tease you? Well, that's because you, scientists, with all your formulas, need to learn to accept my EQ methods next to your formulas and in between all your schedules, timetables, solutions, chaos. You have to accept my methods of work. But unfortunately, you can't call me and you can't ask me what's your method of work, because I have to show it to you, and I can only show it when it pops up. I can't give you a book with formulas. So the little mistake made by CERN with the speed of light was destined by the gods and goddesses. I know that somebody resigned over it. Well, that wasn't needed, because it wasn't evil. So you have to, you are able to separate evil from good practices while G&G teases mankind. And mankind needs to be teased, because otherwise we have scientists who believe that they can build a time traveler's machine, and they don't understand the first thing about higher powers in the galaxy. What do you have to do on 31 December 2012? I had it in my mind this morning when I was still calm. you have to evaluate EQ, your EQ. And you have to try to do as I did, far away from your scientific brain. Focus on the emotions and focus on the truth of the emotions on your timeline. Which intuition was right and which intuition was wrong. And you have to do that because you can only build your time traveler's machine when you accept that you need 50% of my skills. You need people with my skills. And not 51-49%, not 60-40, no, 50-50. You can only travel in time when you understand how people like me travel in time. I have said to Brian, I already know that in 20 years time or so, moving forward to the end of your career, you will be able to predict the future in the galaxy from your world, your technology, your thinking pattern, completely you, your atmosphere, your coordinates in the galaxy, your work with colleagues. But you can only predict it when you understand me. When I am 20 years older, I will not be a technology scientist. But I will be able to refine the fourth dimension better. And I will be able to feel which gaps the technology scientists run into. And then you have to work with it, because when you move forward or backwards in time, I think you can only build a machine that goes backwards in time. You need a lot of more intelligence when you want to move forward. When you go backwards in time, you want to know where you finish and how you can relate to the people backwards in time, and how you can departure from that moment back to today. So what you really want to know is the skill, how you can travel back in the people's mind, in the people's fantasy. And that fantasy is already available in your own brain. And that's why you need the new formulas. My behavioral pattern, my thinkings, next to yours. So you now have to work from your own world, your own interpretation with what I say. The assignment is that you open your eyes on the 1st of January, and that you at least are aware of the evolution and evaluation of EQ you had in 2012. And it would be very nice if you could predict your own development of EQ for 2030. Okay. Sometimes I think I don't need to know what 2013 will bring, because I think that we will have more wars from Turkey into Lebanon, all caused by Russian, by the United States, by the International Criminal Court. Sometimes I think it's a miracle that I don't freak out, that I'm still able to put everything in perspective and categories. And it's very frustrating to see that I'm right, you know, about Syria. I'm very angry with Russia, because Russia could have prevented Syria from being demolished. Turkish politicians want war. Not the Turkish people, but the Turkish politicians. I say they want war because they refuse to go to courts to start law cases against Syria. Russia says, well, we don't interfere in national communities. The people in Syria have to find a solution for their own conflict. Well, that's a complete lie. Russia wants ICC to be a lobby and assassination platform. ICC is 50% American. It's all lobby. We in the Netherlands don't have ICT security. We only have cybercrime that is about to explode in our face. When we have that type of cybercrime, we will have more slavery, a new type of slavery, human trafficking, more sexual assaults in war zone, etc., etc. So the whole thing is connected with the International Criminal Court. CERN is connected with ICC, whether you like it or not. CERN is I trust the intelligence of the people of CERN. I really think of you as a group of people who are far ahead of mankind, the average personalities. I trust you to be smart enough to be a solution bringer for cybercrime, for example. But when the lobby is so big and you can't work with your intuition as you should do it, like I do it, you lose your position as a future bringer in your cybercrime world, in your cyber world. So I think 2013 is going to be more chaos, very angry populations worldwide, and that the people will no longer accept all the bullshit and the lies of the United Nations, of the European Union, of the Nobel Prize winners, of the universities. It's a kind of implosion. Even further, some of you will understand what's going on in the Netherlands. I said it a week ago. The Dutch court system has proven not to be a court system. And that's based on the letter the International Criminal Court sent me on 22 August 2012. And the Dutch court system really doesn't want ICC to be a fair court. Does not want to protect the state of law, the Netherlands. They don't want to work with human rights treaties while they are moving about on the lobby platform behind ICC. Technology, universities, etc., etc. That is going to be a disaster. Because the people suffer, and the people in the Netherlands will suffer more. We will have all the things I have been telling people about, the number of unemployment, the loss of privacy and security will become more visible and touchable. And the majority of the people will not know how to handle it because they never developed their thinking pattern. And I can make 300 videos. People move forward very slowly based on my videos. So, I think I've said it all now. I don't make a wish for 2013. I'm absorbed by this moment. I leave you here. And I wish you wisdom on 31 December 2012. EQ wisdom. See you.